In 2020, DDR3 memory is now officially more expensive than DDR4 memory. And you're probably sitting here scratching your head like, how and why is this possible? Well, in today's video, I'm going to go through all the factors at play here. But of course, there's the biggest one at play, and that is used price performance or older stuff is still in such high demand. And I'm not saying this because I'm a big advocate of used price performance here on the channel with Tech Yes City. I'm saying this because this is just how it is. When you go get a used build, a used second, third, fourth gen OEM, most of the times that's going to have maybe 2, 4, 8 gigabytes maximum of DDR3 memory in it. And most people wanting a gaming PC want 16 gigabytes of RAM. So there's already pent up demand for extra DDR3 memory, especially new. Then there's also on top of that, another thing you can do with used builds that you can't do with a new build, and that is you got a Windows 7 OEM sticker on it. You can grab that, slap it in a case, and you don't even have to buy any Windows 10 license at all. So there's things that used price performance can do that new can't. And of course, that's coming in, especially on the entry level, where you can get a mid-range graphics card, and I've covered this heaps of times here at the channel in the past, you're not going to be losing a whole lot of performance. Then, of course, there's motherboard manufacturers, especially on AliExpress. These guys are making new motherboards for these older platforms with a lot of these older Xeons that are coming out of servers. They're taking the Xeons out, but since the motherboards aren't being manufactured anymore, and of course, used motherboards are clonking out on people with builds, the CPUs are still fine, there's this pent-up demand for new motherboards that support DDR3. So basically, demand for the DDR3 memory is there in 2020. I just didn't realize that there was so much demand for it that it would send the prices of the memory more than DDR4. So what we've got here is, for example, an Australian retailer. So we're going to pop this up. We've got here a 8 gigabyte stick of DDR3 memory going for $49. Now, we look at, and the speeds are 1600 megahertz, and this is the cheapest I can find in Australia here. Then we've got a DDR4 stick of memory, 2666, going for $45. So this is true. I'm seeing this in the retailers, not just the spot exchange prices. So we'll look at that now. There's two different spot exchanges, and they're reporting the same data here. And so what we can see is this top one. We've got to pay attention to this, because basically with DDR4, you can put a single side and have an 8 gigabyte stick. And that's going for an average of $2.62, right, for those little chips. Then we've got here, right, you can compare these. If you want to compare apples to apples, sure, you can do that. But most people just want to get the cheapest stick possible, right? If we're talking about getting the cheapest stick possible and putting in a dual channel, this is what a lot of people can do. And of course, you can overclock this stuff, just like you can overclock this stuff right here. But this right here is going for $1.46 for 4 gigabytes. And so of course you double that and you get $2.92. So it is right. It is going for 30 cents more to get an 8 gigabyte stick together than it is for an 8 gigabyte stick of DDR3 memory. So there's your problem right there, and it exists. The prices are officially more expensive, but there's also some other factors at play. Of course, we've got the pent up demand there, which is causing the prices to go. But another reason being is that we've had the factories that make DDR3, a lot of those switched over to DDR4. And so the actual production of DDR3 memory as a whole, compared to what it was, say, 5 years ago, is down in general. And it's not like they can go back and make another DDR3 RAM factory, because I guess they perceive that as being an unreliable option. It's not consistent. They don't know when DDR3 memory might become out of fashion. And if you've invested all this money in a factory, then you could really come into some financial pain. So the factory and the production line isn't there to begin with too. And then there's the next reason right here, and that goes hand in hand with why the factories wouldn't be willing to invest and make a whole new DDR3 production line. And that is, this stuff's been out for 13 years. It's been released since 2007. So that's, I guess, in a nutshell, what's going on with DDR3 memory. But me personally, I look for this stuff used. I sometimes buy it new in batch quantities, and the suppliers are telling me when they give me the quote list for the prices of DDR3. This is why I'm making this video. I saw the quote list and I'm like, I'm scratching my head, and just like you guys are scratching your head, I'm like, what? This is the first time I've seen DDR3 now more expensive than baseline DDR4 memory. And I asked them, I'm like, did you guys make a mistake? And then they said, nah, that's just how it is. And so I'm like, whoa, like, what is going on here? And so I guess, especially with what's going on around the world at the moment, a lot more people are staying home. There's a lot more demand for gaming PCs. And because, say, for instance, you've got such a weird thing going on where cases and power supplies will be out of stock. So a lot of people will turn to the used market for gaming PCs. And so all the guys like me who put together PCs are now suddenly on overdrive putting together more gaming PCs and like, damn, run out of DDR3 memory. And that's exactly what is happening to me. I'm running out of DDR3 memory. I mean, I did come into a recent stash from two sources. I got a guy locally here, Ed. He sold me a heap of DDR3 memory. And then I also cleaned out Darth Jar Jar for 48 gigabytes of the stuff. And so that's when you're in a clutch situation, you got to make some sacrifices and perform. And so that's what I'm doing personally with DDR3 memory. But another thing as well, this is another thing to think of. If you're building yourself a personal rig, I'll show you guys an option that you may wish to consider. And that is DDR3 ECC registered. Now, this is not going to work on standard i7s. For instance, an i7-4770 is not going to be able to support this stuff. But you can just see the sheer price, right? $60 Aussie. If you buy four of these kits, so if you're doing builds, you can buy four. You can get 128 gigabytes of this stuff for $200 Aussie, which would be, I'd say, close to around 140 US. That's a heap of memory. That's like about 25% of the price of our DDR3 memory on the market at the moment. That's what you can get it for. So DDR3 registered is definitely an option if you like to delve in the land of Xeons like I do. So you can get a second gen Xeon with an X79 AliExpress board. Some of them are pretty decent, by the way. And then you get 16 gigabytes of this stuff. And you'll have a 16 gigabyte gaming PC for a lot cheaper than going with the i7 standard consumer route. And so especially the value on some of those Xeons, you can get like an 8-core 16 thread second gen that'll still play games absolutely fine with an RX 470 and stuff like that. You can still get that stuff really cheap. And I've made videos on this in the past with cheap Xeons, but this is a real benefit. When you look at the price of this stuff, ECC registered memory, this is a real benefit to used price performance at the moment. This one's a little bit of a gold mine. But getting back to the topic of why ECC registered DDR3 memory is very cheap, that's because it's being pulled off servers at the moment in mass. And they're pulling the Xeons out of those things. But at the same time, there's not that much demand for it because everyone wants the i5 and the i7, which doesn't support that stuff. Then on top of that, you've got really in the server industry, there's only demand for DDR4 ECC registered. And that's why you'll see the prices of that generally comes in more expensive than DDR4 unbuffered. So you've got the reverse situation going on in DDR3 as to what's going on in the DDR4 world. So if you guys are into building gaming PCs, you just may wish to consider getting some DDR3 registered stuff and going with a Xeon. That's just an option. It's something I'm going to be looking into seriously myself, being strained for memory right now. But as it stands, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully it was a lot of insight. And let us know in the comment section below what you think of DDR3 RAM pricing. Have you done many builds yourself with DDR3? Do you do more DDR4 builds? I mean, the way prices are going, this is definitely going to be pushing people in the direction of new builds. I've thought about it. I'm like, what's the point of building an older system when you've got, like, say, for instance, a Ryzen 3 3100, you can get an A320 motherboard and DDR3 memory and then overclock it a little bit, or just clock it to 20. You know, some of those boards are actually really good. I shouldn't say overclock it because you can't really overclock on a lot of A320s. But some of those boards are really good where they've got profiles in them where you can just lock in these memory profiles and they work really well. And you can get 3000 megahertz out of even just the cheap stuff. But do let us know in the comment section below what you're doing at the moment and what build you've got going on, because I love reading your thoughts and opinions as always, just like this question of the day here, which comes from VexU666. And they asked, did you try the same motherboard with another CPU? Could also be the PCIe slot. So this question, I answered it in the first minute of the video. And yes, I did try multiple different motherboards. That wasn't the problem. But if you've got a question, like, and you want an answer, please at least watch the video, or at least the first minute of it. Anyway, guys, I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to hit that like button for us. And also, if you're enjoying that content enough and you stayed this far and you want to see it the moment it drops, that sub button, it's down there. You just have to click on it, ring the bell, and you'll get notified as soon as these videos drop around Tech Yes City. And I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.